upon a time,
I wish,
in a far-off kingdom,
more than anything,
lived a young maid,
more than life, more than jewels,
I wish,
and a childless baker,
more than life,
I wish,
with his wife,
more than anything,
more than thunder,
I wish,
the king is giving a festival,
more than life, I wish,
I wish to go to the festival,
more than riches,
I wish my cow would give us some milk,
more than anything,
I wish we had a child,
You wish to go to the festival?
The poor girl's mother had died.
You, Cinderella, the
what,
festival?
You wish to go to the festival?
The festival? The king's festival?
And her father had taken on a new wife.
The festival?
A woman with two daughters of her own.
Who looked at your nails? Look at your dress?
People would laugh at you.
Nevertheless,
I still wish to go to the festival and dance before the prince.
All three were beautiful at face, but vile and black of heart. Jack, on the other hand, had no father, and his mother, well, she was at her wit's end.
I wish my son was at home. I wish my house was at base. I wish the cabin was in the field. I wish the walls were full of gold. I wish a lot of things. Foolish child, what heaven's knight are you doing with the town inside the house?
A warm environment might be just what mere blood needs to produce this milk.
It's a she. How many times must I tell you that he needs to give milk?
The milky one's been in here for as long as I've known him.
Well, I come in, little girl. I wish it's not for me, it's for my granny in the woods. Poor old hungry granny in the woods, just a loaf of bread. Cinderella's stepmother had a surprise for her.
I have emptied a pot of lentils into the ashes. If you can pick them out in 2 hours' time,
you may go to the ball with us.
And perhaps a sticky bun for four.
Birds in the sky, birds in the eaves and the leaves and the fields and the castles and
it's the woods, it's the woods.
Father said be good, Father said be nice, that was always their advice. So be nice, Cinderella, good, Cinderella, nice, good.
Tiger!
What's the good of being good? Everyone is blind, and you're always left behind. Never mind, Cinderella, kind, Cinderella, nice, good, nice, kind, good, nice.
Never talk!
Sorry.
Claude!
Because the baker lost his father and mother in a baking accident, well, at least that's what he believed, he was eager to have a family of his own, and was concerned that all efforts until now had failed.
Who might that be?
We've sold our last loaf of bread.
It's the witch from next door!
We have no bread!
Of course you have no bread.
What is it you wish?
It's not what I wish. It's what you wish. Nothing cooking in there now, is there?
The old enchantress went on to tell the couple that she had placed a spell on their house.
What spell?
In the past, when you were no more than a babe, your father brought your mother and you to this cottage. They were a handsome couple, but not handsome neighbors. You see, your mother was a child and she developed an unusual appetite. She took one look at my beautiful garden and told her father what she wanted was greens, greens, and nothing but greens. Parsley, peppers, cabbages, and celery, asparagus, and watercress, and fiddle birds, and lettuce, and all right. But it wasn't quite, because I caught him in the oven in my garden one night. He was robbing me, raping me, rooting through my meat and egg, raiding my arugula lump, and ripping up the rapier, and cherries, my favorite. I should have laid a spell on him right there to turn him into stone or dog. Your officer, man. Well, the rampion, I had lots to spare. In return, however, I said fair is fair. You can let me have the baby that your wife will bear. I will God swear.
I had a brother?
No, but you had a sister.
But the witch refused to tell him any more of his sister. Not even their name was Rapunzel. She went on.
I thought I had been more than reasonable, that we all might live happily ever after. But how was I to know what your father had also hidden in his pocket? You see, when I inherited that garden, my mother warned me I was never to lose any beans.
Beans?
The special beans. I let him go. I didn't know he'd stolen my beans. I was watching him crawl back over the wall when bang, crash, and the lightning flashed. And, well, that's another story. Never mind. Anyway, at last the big day came, and I made my claim. I'm not taking away the baby. They screamed and screamed, but I did. And I hid a rose she'll never be reached. And your father cried, your mother died. Mollified, and I laid a little spell on you. You too, son.
No!
That your family tree would always be a barren one.
How could you? I'm so sorry.
So there's no more fuss and there's no more scenes. And my garden thrives, you should see my nectarines. But I'm telling you to say my child kings and queens. Don't you ever, never, ever mess around with my greens. Especially the beans.
Leave no white pocket, catch the best parts you can. Take no less than £5. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
How much is to ask?
No more.
Less than £5. Jack, 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 head in the sun. The house is getting older. This is not the time for dreaming. Midnight in 3 days' time, and you shall have, I guarantee,
A child is perfect as a child can be.
Thank you!
Yes, thank you!
Go to the wood!
Ladies and carriage waits.
You now may go to the festival.
Taking your time?
No, sir. No.
Is that the truth? Well, you see, now I'm resting.
How much for the animal?
No less than 5 pounds, sir.
Now, Jack, why such a sum?
Well, my mother told me...
Mother? Why, boy your age, you'll be off to a center for a second. Beans! 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 Beans!
Come on, Milk, you want. There really are spirits here.
Whither away so hurriedly?
To my grandmother's.
And where might your grandmother live?
A good corner lane further in the woods. Her house stands under 3 large oak trees.
How am I ever going to find a cow as red as blood or a cape as yellow as corn? Or was it a cow as yellow as corn?
The cow is white as milk, the cape is red as blood, the hair is yellow as corn, the fur is pure as gold.
What are you doing here?
Forgot your star.
Go home! I've seen things here that would frighten you for your life.
I wish to help.
No, this spell is on my house.
Our house.
Only I can lift
the
spell.
We've set the spell together.
No, this spell is on my house.
Our house.
No, this spell is on my house.
A cow as white as
milk.
Milk!
Hello there, young lad.
Hello, sir.
What might you be doing here, alone, in the woods?
Well, I was on my way to market, but it appears that I am lost.
And what were you planning
to do?
Sell my cow, sir. No less than 5 pounds.
5 pounds? Where am I supposed to get 5 pounds?
Look, 5 pounds? She must be generous milk to fetch 5 pounds.
Yes, ma'am.
And if you aren't to fetch that sum, what are you to do?
Well, I haven't really thought of that. I suppose my mother and I will have no food to eat.
This is all we have.
Beans.
Beans? Oh, beans! We mustn't give up our beans!
Well, if you feel we must.
What are you doing?
Beans will bring you food, son.
Beans? In exchange for my cow?
Oh, well, these beans are no ordinary beans. These beans carry magic.
Magic? What kind of magic?
Tell them.
Magic that defies description.
My mother would.
You'll be lucky to exchange it for a sack of beans.
How many beans?
Six.
Five.
Yes, 5 beans.
We mustn't part with all of them. Yes. We must keep one for ourselves. Besides, I say they're worth about a pound each.
Yes, 5 beans, 5 pounds.
Could I buy my cow back someday?
Maybe.
Yes, perhaps.
Maybe.
Might.
Rapunzel!
strange name. Strange, but beautiful. And fit for a prince. Tomorrow, before that horrible witch arrives, I will stand beneath her tower and ask her to let her hair down to me.
Oh, well, hello there, little girl.
Hello.
Have you saved some of those sweets for Granny?
Well, I ate all the sweets and half a loaf of bread.
Oh, I bet you did. Well, this is such a beautiful red cape. I do so admire
it. My Granny made it for me.
Oh, did she? I would love to have one just like it.
You look pretty foolish.
I would, wouldn't I? Can I just please see it for
just
a second?
I don't like to feel about my cape. Please give it back.
Then you go and you find it and you take it. I want a child or not. It's a cloak, it's a joke. What's a cloak? It's a stupid little cloak. A cloak is what you make it. So you take it. Things are only what you need them for. What's important is who needs them more.
And so the baker, with his newfound determination, went after the girl with the red cape. After the little girl, she was surprised to find her grandmother's door standing wide open.
How uneasy I feel. Perhaps it's all the sweets. Good day, grandmother. My grandmother, you're looking very strange. What big ears you have.
The better to hear you with, my dear.
But, grandmother, what large eyes you have.
The better to hear see you with, my dear. The better to hug you with, my dear.
Oh, grandmother, what a terrible big wet mouth you have!
The better to hate you with!
And scarcely had the wolf said this, than with a single bound of his mouth was devouring the little girl. Well, it was a full day of eating for both. And with his appetite appeased, the wolf took to bed for a nice, long nap.
Little girl has gone off to eating, no doubt. Or eaten. What is that red cloak sticking from your mouth? It's the cape. I know. I'll cut the cape out from inside of your stomach.
Into a thousand bits.
Shaker, with his newfound determination, feeling braver and more satisfied than he had ever felt, ran back through the woods. As for the lad Jack,
There they go.
Little did they know those beans would grow into an enormous stalk that would stretch into the heavens.
Are you all right, miss?
I just need to catch my breath.
What a beautiful ball gown you're wearing. You must have been at the King's Festival.
Yes.
Oh, aren't you the lucky one? Why are you in the woods at this hour?
I'm sorry, sir, but how do you lose a princess?
What do you mean, lose? You were distracting me, you twit. Look, I think I see somebody over there. Have you seen a beautiful young woman in a ball gown pass through?
I don't think so, sir.
I think I see her over there.
I've never lied to royalty before. I've never anything to royalty before.
Thank you.
If a prince were looking for me, I certainly wouldn't hide.
Well, what are you doing in the woods? And with the cow?
Well, me and my husband, we're undoing a spell.
Oh?
Yes, well, the prince. What was he like?
Very nice prince.
Yes, and?
And? It's a very nice ball.
Yes, and?
And? When I entered, they trumpeted.
Yes, and the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
And what he's told.
Is that all? Did you dance? Is he charming? They say that he's charming.
It's nothing but dance.
Oh, and?
And they made a nice change.
Yes. The prince?
The prince?
Yes, the prince.
He's trying for a prince, I guess?
You guess.
I want you to wide range, and it's all very strange.
Well, are you to return to the festival tomorrow week?
Perhaps.
Oh, perhaps. To be pursued by a prince. All that pursues me is tomorrow's bread. What I wouldn't give to be in your shoe.
Can you look over there? An enormous vine growing beside the little cottage.
I mean, slippers!
It looks like a giant beanstalk rising into the sky!
As pure as gold!
I must get home!
I must have your shoe! Wait! Hey! Wait!
1 minute gone! Better to have. Agreed.
Never wear peplum to a ball
or tea.
Open your mouth.
The difference between a cow and a bean is that a bean can begin an adventure.
Giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible giants in the sky. When you way up high and to look below at the world you left and the things you know. Little more than a glance is enough to show you just how small you are. When you're way up high and you're on your own in a world like none that you've ever known, where the sky is lead and the earth is stone, you're free to do whatever pleases you, exploring things you'd never dare because you just don't care. When suddenly there's a big, tall, terrible giant at the door. She gives you rest, and she draws you close to her giant breast, and you know things now that you never did before. Not till the sky. Only just be made of friends, and all you know she's big, but you don't feel small. Someone bigger than her comes along the hall to swallow you for large. And your heart has learned in your stomach stone, and it really scared me all alone. And it's then that you long for the things you've left, and the work you have, and the little you own. The fun is done. You steal what you can and run. And you scramble down, and you look below, and the world you know begins to grow. The house and your mother and the door. The roof, the house, and the world you'd never thought to explore. Thought you could live in between your back again, only different than before. After the sky, there are giants in the sky. There are big, tall, terrible, awesome, scary, wonderful giants in the sky. Not enough for you, then I will go home and I will get more.
Wait, more money is
a good idea. Yes,
no,
absolutely.
Wait. I'm not sure that I wish to sell. Wait, please. 5 gold pieces. 5 gold pieces. Well, 5 gold pieces. I could buy a new roof and fix the chimney and the floors and baking equipment.
But could you buy yourself a child?
Who are you?
When first I appear, I seem delirious. Explained, I'm nothing serious. Now, could you buy yourself a child?
Not about to put a price on a child.
How badly do you wish a child? 5 gold pieces, 10, 20?
Like I said, I'm not about to put a price on it.
Exactly. You haven't thought of many things, now have you?
Give those back. Those are not yours.
Nor are they Jack's. What money's not important. What's important is your wish be honored.
Wait. Known better than to have left her with you.
She could have just as easily ran away from you.
But she didn't.
But she could have.
But she didn't.
But she could have.
But she didn't.
Who cares? The cow is gone. Get it back. Get it back.
We were just about to go and do that. I can give you this, though.
Don't hand me that.
or you'll wish you never thought to have a child.
I don't like that woman.
I'm sorry I lost the cow.
Sorry, no. Please, go home. I will make things right. No more hunting about the woods for strange objects or hungry little girls and wooden boys. I promise. Go.
Ah, there you are, good brother. Father and I had wondered where you had gone.
I have been looking all night.
For her.
For her?
The beautiful one I danced the evening with.
Where did she go?
Disappeared, like the fine morning mist.
Oh, so she was lovely.
The loveliest.
Oh, I'm not certain of that. I confess, I too have found a maiden. She lives here in the woods.
The woods?
Yes, atop a tall tower with no doors or stairs.
Where?
2 leagues due east, past the mossy knoll.
And how do you manage a visit?
Well, I stand beneath her tower, and I say, Rapunzel, Rapunzel, let your hair down to me. And then she lets down the most beautiful head of hair, yellow as corn, which I climb to her.
Rapunzel, Rapunzel. What kind of name is that? You jest, I've never heard of such a thing.
I speak the truth. She's as true as your maiden. A maiden that runs from a prince. None would run from us.
Yet, one has. Did I muse her or draw her to stay? Why does she run from me? If I should lose her, how shall I regain the heart she has won from me? Agony beyond power of speech. When the one thing you want is the only thing out of your reach.
High in her tower, she sits by the hour, maintaining her hair. Live and becoming, frequently humming a light-hearted air. There only were doors. Agony, all the torture they teach. What's as intriguing
or half so fatiguing
as what's out of reach?
Have I not seen the truth forever? How passionate and charming as my death, I'm handsome.
And to earn war, everything maiden could wish for,
then why now
do I know
the girl must be mad?
You know nothing of madness till you're climbing her hair, and you see her up there as you're hearing her, all the world hearing her. Always 10 feet below, and she's just out of reach. Agony that can cut like a knife. I must have her soon.
Ever again. Children can be quite weird about their animals. You be careful with your children.
I if you didn't got that beanstalk again. Quit while you're ahead, I say. Jack! Jack!
Slippers. They're not really suited for these surroundings. They're not really suited for dancing either.
I'd say these slippers are as pure as gold.
They are everything you could wish for in beauty.
What I wouldn't give to just have one.
One wouldn't do you much good.
Yes, well, was the ball just as wonderful as last evening?
Oh, it's still a nice ball.
Yes, and?
And they have far too much food.
Yes, and the prince.
Oh, the prince?
Yes, the prince.
If he knew who I really was.
Oh, who?
I'm afraid I was rude.
Oh?
And I'm being pursued.
And
I'm not in the mood.
He must have really taken a liking to you.
I have no experiences with princes, castles, and gowns.
Nonsense. Every girl dreams.
Look, sir.
Yes, there she is.
I must run.
Oh. I must have your shoe, please.
Stop that.
Where did she go?
Who? Don't play the fool, woman. The prince. Oh, the one in the ball gown. Ha ha, she went that way. I tried to hold her here for you, but she ran away.
I can capture my own damsel. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Where did he go?
Oh, the prince, of course.
Yes.
He went that direction, but she'll never reach him.
We would have if that mongrel at the cow hadn't molested us.
Wait. Please just let me compare this color to that of your own.
In a tower.
We have three.
Yes, and I almost had the fourth, but she got away.
Well, we've one entire day left. Surely we can find the slipper by then.
We? You mean you allow me to stay?
Well, perhaps it won't take the two of us to get this child.
You've changed. You're daring. Your difference in the rules. More charm, more sharing. You're getting us through the walls. If you could see, you're not the man who started, and
And the exhausted baker and his wife buried the dead Milky White.
You must go to the village in search of another cow.
And what do you suspect I pay for this cow?
Here. Tell them it's magic.
No one with a brain larger than this is gonna believe that story.
Uh-huh. Then steal it.
Steal it?
Yourself to a childless life.
I have a better idea. Oh. Why don't you go get another cow, as I have found a maiden with a golden slipper, and I might obtain it.
Fine.
Fine.
That's just perfectly fine.
Unfortunately for Rapunzel,
what did I clearly say? Children must listen.
No, no, please.
What were you not to do? Children must see and learn. What have I been to you? What would you have me be? Handsome like a prince. How but I am old, I am lonely, I am very sad. Yes, you are ashamed of me. Don't understand. I was not company enough.
I'm no longer a child. I wish to see the world.
don't you know what's out there in the world? Someone has to shield you from the world. Stay with me, princess, wait out in the world, it's true. Princess, yes, but wolves and humans too.
Gave you protection, and yet you disobeyed me.
Did you think I would stay in that tower forever?
I will not share you, but I will show you a world you've never seen.
No, no, please. Count Ottawa, Cal.
Leave me alone.
Haven't I left you alone long enough?
Your questions make no sense. Just go away.
In need of another cow.
Something. Well, look what I have. A golden hen which lays golden eggs.
I don't believe that egg from that hen. Where'd you get it?
I stole this from the kingdom of the giants up there. And if you think that this is something, you should see the golden harp the giant has. It plays the most beautiful tunes without you even having to touch it.
Of course it does. Why don't you go up to the kingdom right now and bring it back and show me?
I could.
You could not.
I could.
You could not, Mr. Liar.
I am not a liar. I'll bring back that bloody harp. You'll see. Come on, hen.
After casting out Rapunzel to a remote desert, the witch was returned to the prince for surprise. And as he leapt from the tower, the thorns in which he fell pierced his eyes and blinded him. Returned for her final visit to the festival.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares. Knowing this time I'd run from him, he spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock where you're standing here, stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? You think, make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought would be his response. And then what if he knew who you are and you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? And then what if you are? What a prince, what a vision. Oh, well, how can you know who you are till you know what you want, what you don't, so then which do you pick? You're safe out of sight.
hear me out.
We have nothing to discuss. You've attacked me once before.
I did not attack you. I attacked your shoe. Here. There's a bean in exchange.
A bean?
Yeah.
Nonsense.
No! America.
I've already lost one shoe tonight. I can't afford to lose another.
I needed to have a child.
That makes no sense.
Doesn't make any sense that you're running from a prince.
Stop!
Here, take my shoes. You'll run faster. Thank you.
Uh-huh.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
You there. Who was that woman?
I don't know.
Lying will cost you your life.
I have done nothing.
Hide the cow!
Hide the slipper! Oh, we have
more! I will take the slipper to the prince, and we will scour the kingdom tomorrow to find the
maiden. No, we need that.
Who will fit the shoe?
No!
So, how dare you go off in search without me?
My apologies, sir. I thought that I
enough might... Enough of what you thought. I employed a ruse and had the entire staircase mirrored with pitch. And there, as she ran down, remained the maiden slipper.
Brilliant, sir. Absolutely brilliant.
I thought so. Though it did create a mess when the other guests left.
And, sir, I have succeeded in obtaining the other slipper.
Give her the slipper and all will come to a happy end.
Who are you, old
when
man?
When first I appear, I seem delirious.
Shut up.
Do as he says. He's obviously a spirit of some sort, and we only need one.
Yes, sir, of course.
It's a dead giant to my backyard!
I heard Jack coming down the beanstalk calling for his axe. When he got to the bottom, he started hacking at it. Suddenly the beanstalk fell, but there was no Jack. For all I know, he's been crushed by an ogre.
Worrying will do you no good. If he's safe, he's safe. If he's been crushed, well, there's nothing any of us can do about that now, is there? We must be off. I need my rest before tomorrow's search commence.
Doesn't anyone care that a giant has fallen from the sky?
He is dead, is he not?
That's what he thought of, I suppose.
The third midnight is here. You have all the objects?
Yes.
Slipper, hair.
Cake, cow.
That cow doesn't look as white as milk to me.
Oh,
it is!
Very white.
Please, not now.
Okay.
Come on. Did you say son?
Son? Wait, son!
Yes, meet your father.
Father, could that be you?
I didn't mean to abandon you, but...
It's working! It's working!
She's milking!
Yes.
On their house. For the baker, there would be no reunion with his father, and he and his wife, bewildered, returned home. The witch, who had been punished with age and ugliness the night her beans had been stolen and the lightning flash, was now to return to her former state of youth and beauty. And Milky White, after a night of severe indigestion, was reunited with the now wealthy Jack. As for the prince, he began his search for the foot to fit the golden slipper. When he came to Cinderella's house, Cinderella's stepmother took the slipper into Florinda's room.
Careful, my toe!
Darling, I know!
What'll we do?
It'll have to go, but when you're his wife, you'll such a life, you'll never need to move!
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain and joined the prince on his horse, riding off to become his bride.
The bride, that's true. Search for the foot that fits.
The prince returned the false bride and asked the other sister to try on the shoe.
Why won't it fit?
Darling, you still cut off a bit of the heel and it will. When you're his wife, you've such a life, you'll never.
The girl obeyed and swallowed her pain, but as she was helped on the back of his horse, he noticed blood trickling from the shoe.
Have you no other daughters?
To which the woman replied,
Only a stunted kitchen wench, which his late wife left behind, but she's much too dirty to show herself.
I insist.
No.
And when Cinderella presented herself and tried on the blood-soaked slipper, it fit like a glove.
This is the true bride.
I always wanted a son.
And much to the dismay of the stepmothers and her daughter, he took Cinderella on his horse and rode off.
No, but it's all within the shoe. This is the perfect bride for you. Fit to attend a prince.
And finally, as for Rapunzel, she bore twins and lived impoverished in the desert until the day her prince, wandering aimlessly, heard a voice so familiar that he went towards it. And when he approached Rapunzel, overjoyed at seeing him, fell to his arms weeping. Two of her tears wetted his eyes and restored his vision.
Choice.
In exchange for her youth and beauty, the witch lost her power over others. When the wedding with the prince was celebrating, Lucinda and Florinda attended, wishing to win favor with Cinderella and sharing her good fortune. But as the sisters stood by the blessed couple, pigeons swooped down upon them and poked out their eyes, punishing them with blindness.
Yeah.
our quarters in due time.
Why expand when we could simply move to another cottage?
No, no, we are not moving. This house is my father's, and it is mine, and someday it will be my son's.
You'll raise your son alongside a witch?
Why does he always cry when I hold him?
Baby's fine. Baby's cry, he's fine. You needed holding as if he were so fragile.
You take him.
I can't take care of him all the time.
I will take care of him when he's older.
We had to go through thick and thin. I never thought I'd be so much. I hadn't been. I'm so happy.
And the baby.
Fine, are you all right?
Yes. You, have you done this to our home?
Always thinking of yourself. Look at my garden.
What of your garden?
Look!
Troy.
What happened? I don't know. I was thrown to the ground. I saw nothing. Well, what could have done this?
Do you think it was an earthquake?
No earthquake. My garden's been trampled. There are footprints.
Who could have done this?
Anything to leave footprints that large is no who.
Do you think it was a bear?
No, bears are sweet. Besides, ever see a bear with 40-foot feet?
Huh? A dragon?
No sportsmarks. Usually they're linked.
Manticore?
Imaginary.
Griffin?
Extinct.
Giant?
Possible. Very, very possible.
No, why a giant in our land? We must...
We must tell someone.
Yes.
Who are you going to tell?
The royal family, of
course.
Yes,
the royal family.
The royal family? I wouldn't trust them to snuff out a rat. But the giant, we'll all have to go to battle. Giants are difficult. Giants have a brain. Hard to out with a giant. Giants are just like us, only bigger. Much, much bigger. To a giant, we're just an expendable bug.
Boom! Crunch. We're moving.
And so the baker proceeded towards the castle, but not before visiting Jack and his mother.
Look, Milky White, it's the butcher.
The baker.
The baker.
What can we do for you?
My house, it's been destroyed.
Yes. Jack has been home with me all day.
The baker told Jack that his mother, that he feared there was a giant in the land.
A giant? I could recognize the giant's footsteps. Maybe I could go to your house.
You'll do no such thing.
Oh, please, 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 anything at all would help.
I'm sorry, but you'll get none from us. No one cared when there was a giant in my backyard. I don't remember you volunteering to come to my aid.
Giant in your backyard is one thing. A destroyed home and dead family is quite another.
Look, young man. Giants never strike the same house twice. I wouldn't worry.
I'm taking this news to the castle nonetheless.
When the baker reached the castle, it was the princess who greeted his news. The story unfolds.
Excuse me, madam. This small man insists upon seeing you.
Princess, I'm here to report the sighting of a giant in the land.
Where did you see a giant?
Well, I didn't exactly see the giant.
Then how do you know that there is a giant?
Our house is destroyed and there are footprints.
That could have been caused by any number of things. Now come along.
Wait.
There was a house not too far from ours. It was visited by a giant not long ago. It descended from a beanstalk. And
Yes, I remember.
Yes, and it almost killed the family.
But that giant was slain. This way, please.
Wait. Princess. We have a child that was very, very difficult to come by. His safety is of utmost importance to me and my wife, please.
Are we entirely through now?
Yes.
I will take this news to the prince when he returns. Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm going off to sell the harp, Jack.
Oh, but Mother, no!
Jack, listen to me. We don't want that harp around when there's a giant on the loose.
But I know how to kill a giant.
Please! We've had
had our fill of giants.
Mother, if I can help...
Enough! Promise me, son, you won't leave this land.
Mother, I'm a man now.
Put a little boy in your mother's eyes. I want you to promise. Promise?
Your house.
We had a baking accident.
Baking accident?
There's no need in scaring the young thing.
You cannot scare her.
Well, I guess Granny will have to do without the bread and sweets. Besides, I have all I can carry.
Why such a load?
Oh, I'm moving in with Granny. We had an accident too. I came home to find our house collapsed. As if a big wind blew it in, I couldn't find my mother anywhere.
Oh no!
So I salvaged what I could, and now I'm off.
Oh, good friends, what news have you? What of Mother's grave? What kind of trouble? Oh no, I can't investigate. I must never go into the woods unescorted. Good idea. I'll disguise myself and see what the trouble is. Thank you, birds.
We'll take you to Granny's.
But no, I'm not taking her to Granny's.
We're not gonna let her go alone.
Fine, I will take you to Granny's.
But I don't need anyone to take me. I've gone many times before.
Yes, but not with such, great winds blowing about.
Exactly, that's why I will take you.
Wait, no, you are going to stay here with the child.
I'm not going to stay here with the baby when a great wind might visit our house too. I know that Mother made me promise, but I'm going to go and find that giant anyway.
Into the woods, it's always when you think at last you're through with it. Into the woods you go again to take another journey.
Into the woods, the weather's clear. We've been before, we've not to fear. Into the woods, away from here. Into the woods to find a giant.
Into the woods, you're giving.
No reason then to hesitate.
Into the woods, it's not so late, it's just another journey.
Into the woods, but not too long, the skies are strange, the wind is strong. Into the woods, the sand is wrong.
Into the woods, to slay the giant.
Into the woods, the shield, the charm,
slay
the winds.
To find the future,
to shield,
to slay,
to flee,
to find,
to fix,
to hide,
to build,
to battle.
Good brother, what a surprise.
Brother, how good to see you.
What brings you into the wood today?
I am investigating news of a giant.
Investigating news of a giant? Even father wouldn't do that. That is business for your steward or less.
Well, what brings you to the woods?
My Rapunzel has run off.
Run off?
She's a changed woman. She's been given to hysterical fits of crying. Moods that no soul could predict. I know not what to do.
What a pity.
And Cinderella?
She remains well.
Does she? Now, brother, do tell what you're really doing here.
High in her tower, like yours was, but higher, a beauty asleep. Far on the tower, a thicket of briar, 100 feet deep. Agony, no frustration more keen.
the casket, entirely of glass. No, it's unbreakable. Inside, don't ask it, a maiden no less, just as unwakeable. What unmistakable agony is the way always barred. She has skin white as snow.
Did you learn her name?
No, there's a dwarf standing guard. Agony, such that princes must weep.
Always
enthralled most to anything, almost or something asleep.
If it were not for the thicket.
A thicket's no trick, is it thick?
It's the thickest.
The quickest is pick it apart with a stick.
Yes, but even one brick is my thing about blood.
Well, it's sick.
It's no sicker than your bang with dwarves.
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 Dwarves are very upsetting. Not forgetting the tasks unachievable. Mountains unscalable. If it's conceivable, but unavailable. Agony. Woe not to know what you miss.
While they lie there for.
And you cry on their beers, what unbearable bliss. Agony that can cut like a knife. Ah, well, back to my wife. I must be off. Godspeed, brother.
Godspeed.
And after hours of searching for Granny, our intrepid travelers lost not only their way, but their patience as well.
Are you sure this is the right direction?
We went down the dell.
Maybe we've lost our way.
The path is straight.
What straight? There is no more path.
Where's the stream? Where's the lily pond? Where's Granny?
Calm down. Maybe we should just turn back.
No!
Look. Just have to find Granny's without the path.
But Mother warned me never to stray from the path.
The path is straight from you.
Wait, that looks familiar. See in the distance, three oak trees.
Yes. Yes, yes, I recognize the...
Oh. Wait, wait. Shh. Who's that?
The steward in the royal family. What are you doing here?
The castle's been set upon by a giant.
Giant, why didn't you do anything? I warned you.
I don't make the policy. I just carry it out. And I warned you not to trust the royal family to solve all your problems. Oh, dear. Maybe we should just go back. I wouldn't be too fast if I were you. All that's left of my house is a sack of things. And there's not much left of your house either.
Oh, no.
Where is the lad who climbed the beanstalk?
There is no lad here.
Yes, we've not seen him.
I want the lad who killed my husband.
Wait right there. We'll get him for you.
It was you who destroyed our house. Not a great witch. It's because of you I have no mother.
And who destroyed my house? That boy asked for shelter, and then he stole our gold, our hen, and our harp. And then he killed my husband. I must avenge the wrongdoings.
We are not responsible for him!
Quiet, take your breath.
She's right. There's no reasoning with a dumb giant.
Not all giants are dumb. Give me the boy.
We told you he's not here.
The girl is telling the truth.
I know he's there, and I'm going to wait right here until he's delivered to me.
The giant, who was nearsighted, remained convinced that she had found the lad. There was no consensus among them as to which course of action to take.
Why don't you put a spell on her?
If I still had my powers, I would. Besides, you think I'd still be standing here with all of you? Oh, don't take it personally.
I'm waiting.
You must understand, these are not people familiar with making choices. Their past experiences in the woods had in no way prepared them for a force this great.
How about a blind girl instead?
How dare you?
Oh, put them out of their misery.
We're not that miserable. She doesn't want a woman anyway.
Then what would you suggest we do?
I'm still waiting.
It is interesting to examine the moral issue at question here. The finality of stories such as these dictate. Sorry. I tell the story. I'm not part of it.
That's right.
Not one of us.
You're always on the outside.
That's my role. There must always be someone on the outside.
You want to be on the inside now.
You're making a big mistake.
Nonsense.
No, you need an objective observer to pass the story along.
Maybe some of us don't like the way you've been telling it.
If you drag me in this mess, you'll never know how your story ends. You'll be lost. Think of the baby.
Stop. She's right. Let her go. Put that away.
Now that's better. Do you really want to live in a world of chaos? There must always be an outside observer.
Here's the lad!
I'm not the lad!
This is not the lad. Must I search amongst you for the lad?
No!
Zach is just a boy! We've had no food to eat. These old beloved cow in exchange for magic beans. If anyone is to be punished, it's the man who made that exchange.
That's right!
Shh! He was your responsibility. Now I must punish him for his wrongs.
We've suffered too! You think it was a picnic disposing of your husband's remains?
You're getting me angry!
What about our anger? What about our loss? Who's been flouncing through our kingdom?
Shh. Quiet.
I'll hide my son and you'll never find him.
I'm warning you.
Don't upset her.
You'll never, ever find him. And if you don't go back, this instant will get you for all that you've done. We'll get you.
Where is your son? Is that him?
No!
If he is not, I will return and find you.
Rapunzel, no!
Wake up! She's not doing well.
Don't let them get trapped.
Okay, we won't.
Okay, I promise me you won't let him be hurt.
I promise.
He's dead.
I'll go with you.
No, you are going to stay here with the child.
Why don't I just leave the child with him?
You would leave our child with her.
He'll be fine. The giants won't come for her.
Well, how do you know that the giant won't return?
I just know.
But how do you know?
What if it would only take a giant's footstep to shut you up?
Please, just stay here.
Do you two always argue like that?
Not always.
Seems like you do.
There's nothing wrong with a little arguing.
Oh, I see.
Milky!
There's the boy.
Jack! Jack!
Here. Stay with the baby.
But I want to come.
No, stay here. I will only go 100 paces, and if I don't find him, I'll come right back.
Don't go too far, please.
I won't.
One, two, Jack! Jack!
82, 83.
Jack! Jack!
84, 85, 86.
Well, hello there, sir.
Hello.
You must be here to find the giant.
Yes.
Have you seen the giants?
No.
I have.
You have?
Yes.
And why are you alone in the woods?
Well, you see, me and my husband, oh, it's a long story.
And he would let you roam alone in the woods?
Well, actually, it was my idea. I'm here to find your lad.
Your idea? How brave.
Brave?
Yes.
Anything can happen in the woods. May I kiss you? Any moment we could be crushed. Don't feel.
Well, yes, I do.
And I have a
baker.
Well, of course, you're right. How foolish of me. Foolishness can happen in the woods once again. Any moment big or small is a moment after all. Seems the moment skies may fall any moment. Right and wrong don't matter in the woods, only feelings let us meet the moment unblushed. Life is often so unpleasant, you must know that as a peasant, best to take the moment pleasant as the moment for the moment.
Jack!
Tree is fallen. Your mother's grave's destroyed.
I'm so sorry.
My dreams have just been crushed.
Don't say that. That's not true.
It is true. You wouldn't understand.
I can't just stay here. There's a giant on the loose.
I'm sure that the prince will see to it that the giant is rid from our land.
Oh, the prince. Oh, he's probably off seducing some young maiden.
What?
That's what princes do.
Not all princes.
You know, you look just like the princess. Dirty. Oh, you are the princess, please. I'm so sorry, forgive me.
I'm not a princess out here.
What are you to do?
I have to go back to the castle.
You haven't heard. The castle's been set upon by a giant.
And the prince?
We came upon the royal family earlier, and he was not with them. safe in my company.
I must leave you.
Why?
The giant.
Oh, I had almost forgotten. Will I see you in the woods again?
This was just a moment in the woods, our moment, shimmering and lovely and sad. Leave the moment, just be glad for the moment that we had. Every moment is a moment when you're in the woods.
Now, I must go off to slay the giant. That is what the next moment holds for me. I shall not forget you. How brave you are to be alone in the woods, and how alive you've made me feel.
What was that? Was that me? Was that him? Did a prince prancing about the woods? It's not perceiving what is about the woods. Back to life, back to sense, back to child, back to husband. No one lives in the woods. There are vows, there are ties, there are needs, there are standards, there are shoulds and shots. Why not both instead? There's the answer if you're clever. Have a child for a boy and a baker and a prince for whatever. Never against these walls. Face the facts, find the boy, join the group, stop the giant, and just get out of these walls. Was that me? Yes, it was. Was that him? No, it wasn't. Just a trick of the walls. Just a moment. One peculiar passing moment. Must it all be either less or more, either plain or is it always, or is it never? And that's what woods are for, these moments of walls. Oh, life made of moments, every now and then a bad one. But if life were only moments, then you'd never know you had one. First a witch, then a child, then a prince, then a moment. You can live in these walls, and to get what you wish only just for a moment. These are dangerous walls. Let the moment go. Don't forget it for a moment, though. Remember what you had and can't bring your back to more. Makes the or me more than it did before. Now I understand.
Sure, she returned.
No, I should go look for her. Which direction did she go?
Please, please,
please, please. No.
Please don't let him give me to the giant.
It's not our fault the giant wants you.
You're hurting me.
Let go of him.
Leave him alone.
Where did you find her white scarf? Where is she?
I came up on under a tree.
He was sobbing over her like his own mother.
How awful.
How did this happen?
I buried her in a footprint.
This is all my fault. I should have just stayed with her.
A
remorse will get you nowhere.
My wife is dead!
Wake up! People are dying all around you! You're not the only one to suffer loss! When you're dead, you're dead. Now let's get going before we're all so much
dead. Keep your hands off him!
No!
No, she's right. He's the one to blame. It's because of you that there's a giant in our midst and my wife is dead.
But it isn't my fault. I was giving those beans. You persuaded me to turn away my cow. Well, beans, and without those beans, there'd have been no stock to get up to the giants in the first place.
Wait a minute, magic beans for a cow so old that you had to tell a lie to sell it, which you told. Were the worthless beans, were they oversold? Oh, and tell us you persuaded you to steal that gold.
See, it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it's your fault.
No.
Yes, it is.
It's not.
It's true.
Wait a minute, though. I only stole the gold to get my cow back from you.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't. I'd have kept those beans, but our house was cursed. She made us get a cow to get the curse reversed.
It's your father's fault that the curse got placed in the place that cursed in the first place.
Oh, that's his fault.
Well, it was his fault.
Yes, it is. It's his.
I guess.
Wait a minute, though. I chopped in the beanstalk once. That's clear, but without any beanstalk. Then what's weird is how did the second giant get down here in the first place?
Second place?
Yes.
How?
Well, who had the other bean?
The other bean?
You wanted the other bean.
I didn't. Yes, I did.
So it's your fault.
No, it isn't, because I gave it to my wife.
So it's her fault.
No, it isn't.
But whose is it?
Wait a minute. She exchanged that bean to obtain your shoe, so the one who knows what happens to the bean is you.
You mean that old bean that your wife pulled here, but I never knew, so don't look here.
See, it's your fault.
But...
yes, it's her fault.
But...
and it isn't mine at all.
But what?
Well, if you hadn't gone back up again,
we would need it.
You agreed it should need that.
But I got it for my mother.
So it's her fault, then.
So what about the harp in the third place?
The harp, yes.
She went and dared you.
I dared you.
She dared you. She said that I was scared to.
No, I didn't.
So it's your fault.
No.
You hadn't dared to.
And you had left the harp alone. We wouldn't be in trouble in the first place.
She had risen.
It was your fault. Your fault. You raised the beans in the first place. Your fault. You're responsible. You're the one to blame. It's your fault.
Did you? Had to get your prince, had to get your cow, had to get your wish, doesn't matter how, anyway, it doesn't matter now. It's the last midnight, it's the boom splat. Nothing but a last midnight, everybody smash. Really matters is the blame. Someone you can blame. Find out that's a thing you enjoy placing the blame. If that's the aim, give me the blame. Just give me the boy.
No!
No. No. You're so nice. You're not good, you're not bad, you're just nice. I'm not good, I'm not nice, I'm just right. You're all liars and thieves like his father. Like your son will be to a white father. You'll just do what you do. It's the last midnight. It's the last time. So it's 4 past midnight. Soon you'll see the making you rich.
Go.
Plant them and they soar. Listen to the roar. Die by the score. You can blame another witch. It's the last midnight. It's the last buzz. So before it's past midnight, I'm leaving you my love. Oh.
shouldn't have stolen from the giant.
Maybe I shouldn't have strayed from the path.
Maybe I shouldn't have attended the ball.
Yes. Maybe you should have.
Where are you going?
Away from here.
But you said we had to figure out a way together.
Don't you understand? It doesn't matter if we're together or apart.
I need your help.
No. I needed my wife's help. And now she's gone.
I depended on her for everything.
You would leave your child?
My child would be happier in the arms of a princess.
But wait! All right. All right, come on. Jack!
She died, I ran from my guilt. Now, aren't you running from yours?
No.
Aren't you making the same mistake I made?
No more questions. Please. No more tests. Comes the day you say what for. Please. More.
Disappoint, we disappear, we die, but we don't.
What?
Disappoint, in turn I fear, forgive though they won't.
No more riddles. No more jests. No more curses you can't undo, left by fathers you never knew. No more quests, no more feelings, time to shut the door, just no more.
Running away, let's do it, free from the ties that bind. No more despair, no burdens to bear, out there in the yonder. Running away, into it, where do you have in mind? Have to take care, unless there's where, you'll only be wondering why. Just more questions, different kind. Where are we to go? Where are we ever to go? Running away, we'll do it. Why sit around resigned? Trouble is some, the farther you run, the more you feel undefined. For what you have left undone. And more, what you've left behind. We disappoint, we leave a mess, we die, but we don't.
Disappoint, turn, I guess, forget though, they.
Like father.
Giants waging war. Can't we just pursue our lives with our children and our wives till that happy day arrives? on the wolves, on the lies, the false hopes, the goodbyes, the reverses. All the wondering what even worse is still in store. All the children. All the giants.
I knew you wouldn't give up. You wouldn't leave this baby.
It looked like he was going to.
You mean my son? Why does he always
come out when I hold him? Now what are we to
do? We have to think of something before the giant returns.
Well, what is there to think of?
Well, no, we have to think.
If there was just some way that we could surprise her.
She's too tall to surprise.
Oh, good prince, I need your help now more than ever.
What of the prince?
I don't care. What's important now is we have to find a way to fell this giant. How can you help? You can do that? How can I ever thank you?
You can talk to birds.
The birds will help.
How?
When the giant returns, we'll swoop down and peck her eyes out till she's blind.
What good will that do?
She'll get angry.
And she'll crush us all.
Smear the ground with pitch. Lure her to an area smeared with pitch. Her feet will get stuck, and she won't be able to move.
Yes. Once she's blind, she'll stagger about.
And I will strike her from behind.
Yes. How are we going to strike her? And we'll lure her to where?
Yes, where?
What tower?
There is an old tower between those two trees in the far off distance of maybe a kilometer. Right there, main street.
Yes, send her to the tower.
Yes.
Yes, okay. Okay, we must get moving. It will be dark soon.
Here.
Thank you.
I'm excited.
Good. Let's go.
Oh, no, not now. Don't cry. I know you want your mother.
Hello.
The giant went that direction.
My darling, I did not recognize you. What are you doing in those clothes? And with a child? You must go back to the castle at once. There is a giant on the loose.
The giant has already been to the castle.
No, are you all right? My love. Why are you being so cold?
Maybe because I'm not your only love, am I?
I love you. I do. But yes, it's true.
Then why? If you had loved me, would you have strayed?
I thought if I had you, then I would never wish for more. Part of me is content and happy as I've ever been. But there remains a part of me that constantly needs more.
I have on occasion wanted more. But that doesn't mean I go in search of it. If this is you, how do you behave as a prince? How would you behave as a king?
I was raised to be charming, not sincere. I didn't ask to be born a king, and I'm not perfect. I'm only human.
I think you should go.
But I do love you.
Then, considered, I have been lost. A victim of the giant.
Is that what you wish?
My father's house was a nightmare. Your house was a dream. Now I want something in between. Please go.
I shall always love the man who ran away.
And I, the faraway prince.
They're almost finished. You see over there, between those two trees? When the giant arrives, we're just going to go over there.
Good.
I wanted to climb the tower too.
Well, I'm glad you're here to help me. What's wrong?
My granny's gone.
Oh no, I'm so sorry.
I think my granny and mother would be upset with me.
Well, why?
They said to always make them proud. And here I am about to kill somebody.
Not somebody, a giant who has done.
Until my mother hears that I have slain the giant.
Jack. Mother is dead.
Dead? What? Was she killed by the giant?
No. She was killed by the steward. See, she struck your mother with a deadly blow to the head.
Why would she do that?
The steward, she was afraid that your mother was provoking the giant, making her angry.
Can no one bring her back?
No.
That steward will pay for this. After we have slain the giant, I will slay her!
No, you will do no such thing.
She must die.
No.
Why not?
Because that would be wrong.
What she did was wrong. She will be punished.
She will be somehow.
How?
I don't know. Stop asking me questions I can't answer.
I'm going to kill her.
Then kill her. No. Don't kill her.
Something's about to linger.
Be wrong.
Quick, tell me where he is.
Over there. You see that tower where the birds are clustered? Jack is hiding there.
Thank you. Now justice will be served and I shall leave your kingdom.
Good birds! She doesn't look happy.
Ouch!
The club is stuck in her head!
They've done it! She's swaying!
She's bleeding all over!
She's beginning to fall!
She's going this way!
The sergeant's spoon can catch the potato. Every knot was one straight rope.
Home and there will be no more killings.
Where am I to go? I have no one to take care of me.
You'll have to take care of yourself now, Jack. It's time.
No, it's not. I'll take care of him.
You will?
Yes, I'll be your mother now.
Look, I don't want another mother. I want a friend. I'm a pet.
Of course, we have nowhere to go. So move in with you!
Oh, no.
But it'll be fun!
My house is destroyed, and there's hardly any room for both of you. All right. You can come and live with me.
And you shall come too?
You won't return to the castle.
I will gladly help you with your house. There are times I actually enjoy cleaning. How proud your wife would have been of you.
How sad it is that my son will never know her. Maybe I just wasn't meant to have children.
Don't say that. Of course we're meant to have children.
But how can I go about being a father with no one to mother my child?
Just calm the child.
Just calm the child.
Look, tell him the story of how it all happened. Be father and mother, you'll know what to do.
Alone.
Sometimes people leave you halfway through the wall.